So number four, we want to find the limit as x approaches 0 from the right of this quantity. So what are we going to do?
Split it.
We can do it. Just look at it separately, right? Okay, so 3x plus 1 over x minus limit as x approaches 0 from the right of 1 over sine x, okay? So as x approaches 0 from the right, this will become what? 3 times 0 plus 1 is?
3.
No, 1, right? Over 0, right? Okay? Minus, the other one is the same, right?
1
over 0. 1 over 0, 1 minus 1 over 0 is?
It's infinity.
It's infinity minus infinity, which is an indeterminate form, okay? So therefore, this is an indeterminate form, and what do you think we should do?
Do we have to make infinity over infinity?
Yeah, the only time you can use L'Hopital's rule is either infinity over infinity or 0 over 0. So you have to have a quotient, right? So what can you do so you can have a quotient here? You can get the LCD, right? LCD being what? X sine x, right? And this is 3x plus 1. What happens? It gets multiplied by sine x, correct? Minus x. Is that good? And maybe we can just simplify. Should we simplify? Or should we just substitute right away? What do you think?
No, not substitute.
Maybe don't simplify because then we'll have more terms, right? So as you let x approach 0, you'll get 1 times 0 minus 0, right? Over 0 times 0. So you get 0 over 0, which is now another indeterminate form, but we know how to handle that. That's by L'Hopital's rule, right? So we do L'Hopital's rule, which is simply what? Differentiate numerator, differentiate denominator. Which one do you want to do first?
3 times sine x.
This one you can differentiate as a
product.
So the first is 3x plus 1 times the derivative of the second, which is cosine x, right? Plus the derivative of the first, which is 3 times the second. Okay, minus the derivative of x is 1. And this is again just using the product rule, right? So the first times the derivative of the second plus the derivative of the first times the second, correct?
Yeah.
And let's see, if we substitute, I guess we get something here, right? We have 0 plus 1 times cosine of 0, which is 1, so we get 1 times 1, correct? Plus 3 times 0 minus 1. Did I do that right?
So it's 0.
And then this is, this is 0, right? And this is what?
0.
0, 0 times 1 plus 0. So again, we have another 0 over 0 indeterminate form. So that means we should do it, the L'Hopital's rule, one more time, right?
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully this is it. Okay, so you have limit as x approaches 0 from the right of what? Let's see. So the same thing, right?
Negative.
So product, so you'll have negative 3x plus 1 sine x. Basically, the first times the derivative of the second
plus three, the
derivative of the first times the second plus the derivative of 3 sine x, which is 3 cos x. Of course, that's 0, right? The derivative is 0. All over what? Same thing, so the first times the derivative of the second, so derivative of cosine is negative sine, right? Where was that? And then first times the derivative of the second plus the derivative of the first, which is 1, times the second, which is cosine x, plus the derivative of sine x, which is cosine x. Did I do it right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. So then let's just see, and hopefully this is it, right? That first term will just be 0, right?
Yeah.
The second term is actually a 3, right? The third is a 3, correct? 3 times 1, 3 times 1. The denominator, you'll have a 0 plus 1, plus 1. Yes. What is it?
3.
So this is equal to 6 over 2, which is 3, and therefore we have found the limit. Okay?
Yeah.
So not so bad. All right.